Thanks, Mr. Slattery. Oi! This way. And then they walked off down the corridor like bosom buddies. I reckon Slattery was just playing along, you know, part of the whole thing.
Oh, yeah? And how do I know you're just not covering yourself?
Because I'm telling you. Hell, what does it take to convince you I am not the lagger?
Fair enough. Maybe Wyndham is the lagger.
Yeah, maybe you'll think twice before you point the finger at me again.
No harm done.
Suppose an apology's out of the question. Yeah, well, what are you going to do about that fat bitch? I mean, you're always telling us you're top dog. How about we see some action, eh?
Well, I'm not doing nothing tonight. Screws will be watching their precious stoolie like a hawk. But I reckon she's going to have a terrible accident in the morning.
Coming?
No, I reckon I'll hang around for the action.
Hurry up and get out of there, Cox.
Oh! Just get into trouble.
Hey, get ready, she's coming.
Move it, Cox.
Morning, everyone.
G'day. How's it going?
I gotta confess it. Morning's not my best time.
Oh, you're right there, Wyndham.
Oh! Wyndham!
Eggbone and Patterson got onto your little game last night.
What are you talking about?
I'm talking about you being the phantom lagger. And you're about to have a nasty little accident on the soapy floor.
Oh, it's not true, Lex!
Don't come crying to me, you rotten lagging bitch!
Oh, we're not gonna kill you. This time.
Screw you!
What's going on here? Wyndham, are you all right?
It's fine.
Have you been causing trouble, Kelly?
No. It's all my own fault. I came waltzing in and slipped on the soapy floor and hit over heels.
Well, be more careful next time. Wilder, Sister Hall's waiting for you up in the infirmary, please.
I haven't had a shower yet.
Well, you can have it afterwards. Now, come on, and the rest of you, hurry up.
Listen to me. I'm no lagger.
No, of course not. No lagger ever is.
We're wasting time, Lou.
Give me a chance and I'll prove it.
Yeah? How?
Give me a day. My bona fides will be vouched for. I promise.
Okay.
Hey, I thought we were doing her now.
Well, she's not going anywhere.
And if she is the lagger, that gives her 24 more hours to sweat it
out. Look, I reckon she's just buying for time. I say we do it now.
And I say we wait. And what I say goes. Right?
All right, wait by the door, Spencer. Morning, Wilder. How are you today?
Better, I think.
That's good. Here's
some water. Thanks.
Don't dawdle. We haven't got all day.
Peter, what are you doing here today? I thought you had an exam today.
Yeah, not till later. I just thought I'd see how you were.
Oh, I'm fine.
How's Dad?
He's gone.
Yeah, I thought he was on early shift.
No, he's gone to Queensland.
Queensland? When?
Last night.
Was he really mad?
No, he wasn't too bad. He just said he'd had everything and he was going to shoot through to Queensland.
He's certainly consistent, isn't he?
Yes, except this time he said he's not coming back.
Good. I'm glad. I'm sorry, Mum. I know it's an awful thing to say, but, I mean, it's the truth. Will you be okay? How are you off for money?
Yes, I'll be all right. I've got a little bit put by and maybe I'll get a job later.
Mum, you're gonna be fine. Job or no job, I'm gonna look after you. Starting right now.
I don't know why you backed off, Lou. We had her cold.
I told you why.
Still reckon it was the old bat.
Careful, Lex. Last night she thought it was you.
Oh, bloody hell, don't start that again.
I ain't starting anything. I'm just pointing out your top dog doesn't seem to be able to make up her mind.
Shut up, the lot of you. I told Wyndham to get her bona fides and she'd better get them pretty quick. Well, she's for the chop.
Talks a lot, doesn't she?
Well, I feel really awful about it. I wish I'd never said anything till I was sure, because I'm not sure.
No, once a wimp, always a wimp. Cut the whinging, Egbert.
I'm not whinging. Admittedly, you haven't got any real evidence. It's all circumstantial.
Oh, save the big words for your friend, the governor. Oh, I forgot, she doesn't come here anymore, does she?
You mightn't be so cocky when the freak gets back.
She's back now.
Well, have a nice day, everyone. The lagger, the freak still on the prowl. Your top dog's really cooking with gas.
Shut your mouth, Connors. It's your fault the freak's breathing down her necks anyway.
Oh, I'm sorry you can't hack her. The freak doesn't worry me a bit. She seems to know what lane I'm in. Isn't that right?
You don't look too good, Joan. Are you sure you should have come back to work so early?
Yeah, I'm fine. But you know as well as I do, with Morris standing in for the governor, we're going to be more short-staffed than usual.
Yeah, but we could have managed without you for a day or two. What you went through was pretty damn rough.
Well, part of the job. Main thing to do is get on with it. And I can assure you that's what I'll be doing.
Well, more credit to you, but don't overdo it.
Margaret, come to my office, please. Does anyone else know about this note?
Of course not. I brought it straight to you.
Good. Well, informers are a mixed blessing. I mean, even if the information is true, we all know what the women are capable of doing to them. We'll all have to watch this situation very closely.
I understand.
Right. Now get Eve Wilder and take her to a cell. I'll send Davis along to help you with the cell search. A by-the-book cell search, Joan.
Of course.
Search me? Whatever for?
I'm sorry, it's prison regulations.
Oh, I didn't think we'd ever come to this. Her dear father would turn in his grave if he knew. She was such a beautiful little child.
I understand how you feel.
A dear little Rita, a pikey. You know, I warned her and I pleaded with her. I said it'll end in tears, and it has. Even now, this is all she's interested in, all she cares about. You know, filthy, awful, degrading as they are, that's all she asked me to bring in. That's the only thing she wants.
You try not to worry too much, Miss Brown, and you keep coming in to see her. I'm sure you'll get through to her in the end.
Yes, thank you.
I don't understand what...
You soon will. Now, let's see.
Please, this isn't fair. I'm not hiding anything.
No? Well, then, what's this? Ah, not a bad trick, Wilder. Wonder what you'll come up with next.
Oh, don't say anything. A bit closer. I want to try and guess. Oh, you're easy. It's Dr. Ryan.
You've won the jackpot. How'd you know?
Oh, it's that trendy aftershave you're wearing.
You're getting too smart by far.
And how are you on this bright morning? It is bright, isn't it?
Very bright.
Good.
Are you allowed to talk to me about work? I mean, the authorities won't haul you over the coals if you talk to me about Wentworth, will they?
Oh, what particularly?
Oh, just the day-to-day life, feeling, atmosphere of the place.
Well, why do you want to know exactly?
Well, I'm training in psychiatry.
Oh.
And I'm doing some research into how people react to being confined.
Oh, I see. And you want to know how the women cope with their term inside?
Couldn't have put it better myself.
Well, if you've got plenty of time, I'm very fond of a chat.
Oh, fire away.
All the same, Doctor,
Steve, please.
Steve, I could talk to you all day, but I doubt if I could make you understand or feel exactly what it's like to be inside a prison.
You have to be there, eh?
Yeah. Yes, I suppose so.
Oh, I've done some stupid things in my time, but this is the...
The stupidest?
No. Having that brat in the first place was the stupidest.
But last night you said...
I don't care what I said last night. She's an aggressive, bad-tempered little thug.
Oh, you'll get through to her love. It's early days yet.
I'm not sure I even want to.
Oh, that's not like you to give up. I bet the kid hasn't had it easy,
you know. Oh, cut the sermon, Mae. Doesn't suit you. Look, there's something much more...